Hi, my name is Vanessa van Dijk, and in this video we are looking into how much you need to use of your chemical exfoliant. Now you can see the examples that I've picked right here, which are some of the famous exfoliating acid products, at least of what I can tell from my YouTube channel. But one thing that they also have in common is that they have a different texture, and based on that you're going to adjust the entire guide. That's why I have picked them. Now I'm referring to leave-on exfoliating acid products. So usually you would apply them in your evening skincare routine. And once you have applied them to the skin, you're going to leave it on the skin for the entire night, and then you're going to rinse it off the next morning. This refers to a leave-on product. Whereas if you should have an exfoliating acid mask, it usually will tell you on the back of the packaging that you need to rinse it off after a certain amount of time. Usually this is between 10 to 15 minutes. And then this guide wouldn't apply to it because you would use the mask a different way. So please make sure to double check the directions on the back of the packaging. If it mentions anything about the rinse off part or not, if it does not mention anything at all, you're working with a leave-on exfoliant. So I have categorized them based on their texture, so that in case you should have maybe the same or something similar to this from a different brand, then you can still refer to this specific guide. So when it comes to the amount that you can see below, I'm referring to this where you're going to apply the product on the palm of your hand at first, and then you're going to rub your hands together and then do the application all over your face and maybe your neck as well. So if you should have an exfoliant that comes with a pump, such as Cosrx BHA Blackhead Power Liquid, use between 1 to 2 pumps. This may be a gel texture or light lotion texture, you can still follow that specific guide. Then if you should have a stickier, thicker, water-based exfoliating acid serum, like the Ordinary Salicylic Acid Solution, use about 3 to 5 drops. If you should have a more lightweight texture, quite similar to water, like the Ordinary Glycolic Acid Toning Solution or the Lactic Acid products, you need to use more, otherwise it's going to absorb so fast into the skin that you haven't had time to blend it properly all over. Therefore, my guide will be using between 5 to 10 drops, so that you have enough time and enough product to blend it evenly all over. And then the last example would refer to exfoliating acids that have a slightly like oilier, thicker like texture. And there the guide would be between 4 to 6 drops. So you can see that the guides are changing a slightly bit depending on the texture and the formulation of the product. So overall, I recommend following that specific guide so that you're not going to overuse it. Because if you're going to end up with too much product that you have applied all over your face and maybe your neck as well, then this can increase the risk of experiencing sensitivity. Because the skin is being exposed to so much exfoliant that it cannot properly handle it. Therefore, it's always recommended to just use enough to apply it evenly and thinly all over, but not more than that. And so therefore you can see my adjustments on what I've done. So now this should help you to figure out how much you're going to use when looking at your exfoliant at home. Now again, this refers to only applying it with your hands. There are certain exfoliating acids like Paula's Choice or the Ordinary Glycolic Acid Toning Solutions, which could be used with a cotton pad as well. And then you just would slightly dampen it and not over soaking it dripping wet. But overall, I do not recommend this method. I used to do it in the past and it works extremely well. But over time, I figured out that while using a cotton pad, you're going to waste quite a lot of product that's not ending up on the skin, but more so in the cotton pad itself. Therefore, my recommendation would be by applying it with your hands, and this just works just as fine, and you can save quite a lot of product at the same time. Now, when doing the application of your exfoliant, please always check on the back of the packaging how you're going to use the exfoliant. Sometimes they will tell you that you can use it on the eye contour, sometimes they will tell you to specifically leave out the eye contour because it's quite a sensitive area, therefore you have to be a bit more careful. Please do not use it on top of your eyelids, do not get it into your eyes, and some may experience a bit of sensitivity around your nose. If that's the case, avoid this part. If everything is fine, you can use it right there as well. And the same can occur around the lip itself and the corners of the lips. So everywhere where you have like experienced slightly sensitivity, you're going to avoid that area. But overall, you can use it over the rest of your face and neck. Please remember that the frequency matters as well. As a general guide, start off by using it once per day, 2 to 3 times per week, and then slowly increase the frequency as your skin is able to tolerate it. And so those are like the general information that I want to share with you when it comes to exfoliating acid products. If you now want to see with some of them an application guide as well, and you want to see the application visually, I'm going to leave some of the videos at the end of this video so that you can keep on watching and see the application too. Now, this is what I wanted to share with you. I do hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did so, please don't forget to give the thumbs up as well as share it. And thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon in the next one. Happy skin caring. Bye.